when I'm choosing which to do, you know, whether it's the perineural injection or the nerve hydrodissection, is all really going to be based on what happened with this patient. Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Daily Doc Talk. I am still your host, Dr. Drew Timmermans. So one of the treatment approaches that I use for patients with neurogenic inflammation that is causing neurogenic pain or neuropathic pain is perineural injection therapies. But another one that we can sometimes use is called nerve hydrodissections. I wanted to spend some time right now comparing and contrasting these two different approaches because there are many similarities, but there are also significant differences between them, which might help in you understanding what therapy might be more appropriate for you when you're looking for a physician or if you're considering coming out to see us. The first is going to be a subcutaneous injection, which is sometimes why we call it subcutaneous perineural injection therapies. And the goal of those injection therapies is to get dextrose, which is the solution that we're using. It's a low concentration, about 5% dextrose. We're trying to get that solution around the nerve bundles, the smaller nerves, the peptidergic nerves that are coming out towards the skin. These are C fibers that are transmitting neurogenic pain and neurogenic inflammation. We're trying to get this fluid, and we're trying to bathe the nerves in the area of the skin that we're treating. And so it's just going to be a short injection into the skin. This is going to be palpation guided because we're a lot of these small nerves, you're actually not even able to see with a normal MSK ultrasound machine. And even for some of the larger nerves like the anterior femoral or the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve, which are still, you know, are large enough that you could see with an ultrasound machine, you actually have to have a really special high powered ultrasound machine to visualize well. Although in some patients you can see it with a normal ultrasound machine. These injections are going to be palpation guided, and the determination of what nerves we're treating is based on where the patient is feeling pain, along with any potential injuries that they might have had to that area, which will help differentiate between the different nerves, as well as palpation, trying to feel any inflamed nerves along the path that we know the nerves should be traveling. And so that's gonna be our first approach, is the perineural injection or the subcutaneous perineural. On the other side of the spectrum, we have the nerve hydrodissection, which we're still trying to accomplish the same thing. We are still trying to reduce neurogenic inflammation and therefore neurogenic or neuropathic pain. However, we are doing the injections under ultrasound guidance. The solution that we use can be the same solution. It can be the 5% dextrose. However, commonly I'm also doing the nerve hydrodissections with different solutions, such as platelet poor plasma. Sometimes we'll enrich that platelet. We'll do a mix between the PRP, the platelet rich plasma, with the platelet poor plasma, just because sometimes the growth factors in the PRP are actually too strong for the nerve and it causes a lot of irritation. Or we could use something like exosomes or one of the amniotic fluid products or a placental matrix product is commonly what I'm using in conjunction with the 5% dextrose solution. The goal is actually twofold for the nerve hydrodissection. The first is we are trying to bathe the nerve in that fluid, which that way the fluid can then exert its direct effect on the nerve to reduce inflammation and break that cycle. The second aspect that we're trying to do is we're actually trying to create mechanical space around the nerve so that the nerve isn't as impinged in that area. It has more room to breathe and therefore it now can function better and is less inflamed. There have been an insane number of rat studies where they have basically loosely tied a suture around a sciatic nerve from the rat with only minimal amount of pressure. And what they see is that small amount of pressure causes pretty big inflammation and swelling of the nerve, which then if the nerve gets swollen, the sutures around it get tighter, and that we kind of get into this kind of feedback loop where the neurogenic inflammation and swelling kind of just perpetuates. We know that if we can create space around an area where there is that swelling and inflammation, that can reduce the tension and compression on the nerve, which can reduce the neurogenic inflammation. There's actually a really interesting study, which I will link below, done on carpal tunnel syndrome showing that there is a positive benefit from the mechanical nerve hydrodissection, as well as the a biochemical effect, a physiological effect of the 5% dextrose on the nerve as well. And so they did a single ultrasound guided nerve hydrodissection of the median nerve for carpal tunnel syndrome. The placebo group was saline, and the experimental group was the 5% dextrose. And what they saw was that over a 6-month period, there was a improvement in pain in the patients who had the saline injection, which to me shows that there's an actual mechanical effect that they were getting. But then there was an added benefit with the 5% dextrose, showing that there's an actual biochemical effect of the dextrose on the nerve. When I'm choosing which to do, you know, whether it's the perineural injection or the nerve hydrodissection, is all really going to be based on what happened with this patient. If we have a heavy surgical patient, so a patient who has had a lot of surgeries, and it's highly, highly likely that one of the nerves was fully damaged, then that's going to, for me, going to be an indication that we might need to go down the route of doing a nerve hydrodissection. If there is a known compression around a nerve, or if in palpating some of the more larger superficial nerves, if we can feel a lot of inflammation at one specific spot where, so that would indicate where there's an actual chronic constriction, then that to me would be an indication that we should do nerve hydrodissection. On the other end of the spectrum, the perineural injections are often a good place to start if we don't have a long surgical history or severe condition or anything like that. But if after time we are not seeing that we are getting the results that we need, and we need to look at deeper branches of the nerves, then doing a nerve hydrodissection could be really important. Because the subcutaneous injections are just a half inch under the skin, we're only really able to affect the superficial branches. We're not able to get at the deep parts of the nerve, whether it's passing through different osteofibrous tunnels or fascial canals or piercing through the muscle or anything like that, which are all potential places for a chronic constriction injury. And so if we need to treat the deeper layer of the nerve where there is a constriction, and therefore that is potentially where the neurogenic inflammation and pain is originating, then we should be looking to treat with the nerve hydrodissection. Really appreciate if you made it all the way to the end of this video. If you have any comments, I would love to hear. Drop a comment below whatever platform you're on. Let me know what time in this video you really appreciated or you found it valuable, so hopefully I can continue to create content like that. All right, everybody, see you later.